Jeffrey Epstein was connected to Robert Maxwell through his daughter, Ghislaine. These two together created a blackmail operation or some sort of sex trafficking operation by leveraging their connections on Wall Street, in the fashion industry, Hollywood, in the royal family, and in politics. From this, they got a lot of money and they bought off the Justice Department. Some of the money is used to fund Harvard University, among other scientists, in AI and genetic manipulation. Robert Maxwell shared this love of science and a control of information, but he was maybe part of MI6, definitely part of British Army intelligence, and also was kind of putty in the hands of the Soviets, as we come to find out. Ghislaine Maxwell is his daughter, who has sisters Isabel and Christine, who basically made the first search engine for the internet, or so we hear. Isabel works for the World Economic Forum, and Christine went on to design some data analytics software that the FBI uses. Christine is married to a guy named Roger Molina, who still works in science, but also runs a magazine about science. His father is Frank Molina, the father of rocketry and Jet Propulsion Labs. He went on to work at the United Nations under Julian Huxley, who wrote the dystopian science fiction novel Brave New World, which essentially runs us all like AI through genetic manipulation. Of course, Frank Molina was partners in that project with a guy called Jack Parsons. Jack Parsons was supposedly a self-taught chemist, and once he got bored with being part of the greatest achievement of mankind, he became an acolyte of Aleister Crowley, a black magician, who invented a religion called Thelema based on the principle that do what thou wilt is the whole of the law. And he partnered with L. Ron Hubbard and to enact this crazy Babylon working ceremony where he wanted to bring in the moon goddess or something. Do you see why this is not a simple video to present to you? I would have felt remiss if I hadn't have told you all these things. On the other hand, some of them seem like red herrings. But you know, it is all connected. I mean, just look at the theme in this graphic. It's all kind of transhuman. It's all very amoral or immoral or depraved or debauched straight up. It's really not the type of thing that you want to think your scientists and greatest minds and the intellectuals are involved in, is it? And yet that's what they rub shoulders with. That's who they're all involved with. This is where their minds go. And that's where all our money is being put. Unfortunately, if they get their way, that's our future. And like founder of The Edge, John Brockman wrote in 1991, "Throughout history, intellectual life has been marked by the fact that only a small number of people have done the serious thinking for everybody else. What we are witnessing," he says, "is a passing of the torch from one group of thinkers, the traditional literary intellectuals, to a new group, the intellectuals of the emerging third culture." The third culture is not a very pretty picture. I prefer the old group, the old guard of literary intellectuals, where we still had our morals and values intact. The pre-World War II intellectuals. I prefer what made North America great. I prefer the principles that the US was founded on.